So, welcome to the first annual Faculty Hall of Fame event. I'm Kurt Asher, I'm Dean of the Library and Chair of the Faculty Hall of Fame Committee. I want to thank everyone who liked this idea and who helped make it possible. The committee that helped me create the bylaws and establish this award was made up of Kathy Knutson, Jackie Kegley, Roy Lefebvre, Mark Evans, Sarah Hendrick, Chris Livingston, and ASI Representative Jose Garcia. After the award was approved by the Senate and Cabinet, we formed another committee chaired by me and made up of Chris Livingston, Teresita Overton, Madi Elisani, Thomas Wallace, Sarah Hendrick, Dayund Saini, and Emerson Case. We reviewed the applications and selected the inductees. I'd also like to thank Eileen Montoya for help getting the food here and all of that, which was a big job. But really, who really made this possible were all the nominators who nominated so many people. We had a lot of people to select from, and I just want to remind you, this is the first time we've done this, and this is like every first step we're learning as we move forward. We expect this event to evolve and grow, and I just like to give a round of applause to all the people who made this event possible. You may be wondering why we decided that this was important. As a library, we're concerned about the record that we have inherited from our predecessors, and how we'll preserve the memories of those who've made this place what it is. We're a community here at CSUB that's ever changing, and people who devote their professional lives and career to CSUB are replaced, and their memory needs to be preserved. It should be with profound gratitude that we look back to those who built our programs and influenced the direction of our university. Our faculty touched thousands of lives over the course of their careers, and we need to remember the great teachers and thinkers who have influenced so many students and made this college built it. Only those professors who are fully separated from teaching are eligible for the faculty hall. Sadly, some of our best teachers are gone now, and five of the six inductees today are going to be posthumous. I think this drives home the importance of this event and commemoration. Inductees will be enshrined on the wall on the second floor of the library with a plaque and photograph, as well as a permanent biography on our website. Which Chris Livingston right there is working on, and we hope that you'll come back and see the exhibit once the plaques arrive and the final touches to the exhibit area are completed. So before we begin this ceremony, I suggest that we all get some food, and once we've been seated, Provost Zorn will give a short talk and then we'll begin the inductions. So please help yourself to lunch.